Previously on Drag Duel, October and Anastasia continued to ruffle some feathers within the group, and with the return of the music video challenge, our warriors were tasked with creating videos for songs from Katy Perry's Teenage Dream. While it was a tight battle for the win between October 3rd and Dom Perignon, Dom pulled out the gold and returned the favor, using their power to take off 30 seconds from October's Round 3 video. And Vuja went from the top to the bottom as he lip-synced in the drag duel against Anastasia Page Milano. And unfortunately, our drag king from Poland became the first warrior eliminated from season 2.
Welcome back to the Drag Duel. Happy Halloween! It is round 3 and we have 10 warriors remaining in the arena. But not for long. At the end of this episode, somebody will be the second warrior eliminated.
Cha-cha-cha, ka-ka-ka. This year, our warriors are fighting for a $2,500 grand prize, courtesy of you. That's right, this year we are using both our Patreon and our Indiegogo funding to sponsor the grand prize.
So if you want to help out, please make sure to join our Patreon, where you not only get a bunch of bonus content, but also the chance to join the arena and chat with the production and the warriors.
The winner of the season will also receive a fabulous $100 custom lash package from our friends at Lash Corp. You can find them on Instagram and Etsy at Lash Corps. And 2 custom press-on nail sets and a bag of gifts that include makeup items, self-care items, and stuff to pamper the winner from the fabulous Kitty Cosmetics.
This week, our warriors were challenged to produce their very own death scenes in the brand new movie Final Destination 6, The Death of Drag.
Their job is to give us a 2-minute death scene inspired by the Final Destination movie formula.
If you're not aware, and you should be, in Final Destination, the characters are stalked by death itself and meet their end in the most gruesome, insane, usually Rube Goldbergian inspired ways.
This death scene can be suspenseful, gory, campy, stupid, whatever they please.
They can use special effects, fake blood, graphics, whatever they want to use to convey their death scene, as long as it fits the formula of Final Destination.
This challenge is a love letter to the franchise that is all about mixing horror and camp elements.
But let's check back in with our 10 remaining warriors after the very first elimination of the season.
Hi, from one spooky bitch to another. Welcome to Drag Duel Halloween Edition.
Happy Halloween!
Hail to the powers of the Watchtowers of the East, am I right?
It felt really good to win, and it felt like earned, and it felt like correct. You know, I worked really hard on the video and I worked really hard on the runway, so it gave me more confidence. It's a good thing because this round, I needed that. I needed the dose of confidence.
Dom was incredible. I predicted he would be incredible. That's why I attempted to disadvantage him. But that obviously did not work out. The only thing that really would have been a disadvantage if he didn't get the song that he wanted. But everyone wanted a different song except for fucking E.T.
It feels like the expectations are high for me and I have to like maintain a certain level and maintain a certain quality, which like I have no problem doing, but it does put a lot of pressure on me, and it does feel like I can't fail. Like I can't have a weak moment.
I was over the world last week when I was in the top. I actually like kind of cried in my reaction. Like I just didn't know how it was gonna be received. So I was like over the moon and ecstatic that I did really great last week. Going into this week, I was like, let me just like try and keep that up and just keep doing what they're liking.
I feel like shit. I feel like absolute shit after being low. At least to me, I didn't feel like I was under any sort of sense of delusion over how I did, because bitch, I remember being so confident. I said, oh, my video 8. Oh, bitch, this runway, nobody is gonna be able to touch this. And then they're like, Kiss, you're low. I was like, oh, okay, cool. So good to know that when I feel good about things, it ends up me being either safe or low. God forbid I feel bad about something, right?
I was low, which was great. I loved it. I was like, yes, give me more low placements. No, yeah, it sucked.
I thought that I'd done really well. Like, not enough to win, but I thought I was definitely gonna be safe. And I was in the bottom 4, and then the bottom 4 turned into bottom 2, and then I had to send Voodoo home, which I am sorry about. But, I mean, I wasn't going home.
I would love to say that things have like dramatically changed since Bujo left, but honestly, they weren't very active before. So it sucks to say, but honestly, it feels absolutely no different.
I did view them as competition, so I was not expecting them to be in the bottom, but then seeing their music video, I was.
I was so sad that Vuho was eliminated first. I was really like, bummed out, and like in the results reaction watching the lip sync, I got like super bitchy towards Anastasia, even though like this whole competition I've been really wanting to stay in my like best mindset and like the way I usually am, which is like everything's subjective, everyone has positive things about what they do, like blah blah blah, like but then after Vero was eliminated, I was like, no, this drag sucks, and here's why. But I apologize, Anastasia, for laying into you. I still believe everything that I said, but I wouldn't usually choose to be quite so, like, bleh about it.
I'm pretty crushed, actually. I'm still not over Vujo being eliminated first, because I'm the only drag king in the competition now. And I have already said, you know, my feelings on being a drag king is that the expectations are just like higher, because people tend to think that drag kings aren't as good or something as the queens that we see. And it's only because there's no show out there. There's, well, besides Drag Duel, there's no outlet to see drag kings in mainstream media. So we're precious, precious commodities, and now I feel like I gotta win it for Bujo.
I guess also another reason that it hit me really hard is because the first like few weeks I found the social like dynamics of the group like really challenging, and I was getting like triggered quite easily and feeling like really like alienated and like not understood, and like feeling like a lot of people weren't even like trying to understand or get to know me, and they just kind of like immediately wanted to go to like these negative places. So that was like really, whoa, like I found that really difficult and like not fun. And Vuho was like the first person that I really like connected properly with, and then literally like 3 days later they got eliminated. So I was like, no, I had a life raft and now it's gone.
Being the one who sent Vuho home, I am happy to still be here, because the past few weeks, I think, challenge-wise specifically, I was happy with what I did, but I wasn't impressing myself either.
I think this upcoming week will be a little more tough, though.
So, with round 2, I obviously thought that I was going to be in the top, but after listening to the critiques that I got, I see what the judges were saying, and I can understand where I need to sort of hone in on certain things to, you know, just have made the video better. Our little safe group, it's maybe a different situation for each of us.
People were telling me that they thought that I was gonna be low, bottom, or whatever, and really every single week people have been telling me that every single week, and it's my friends in the competition, which is also like, ah. But yeah, I was relieved to be safe.
I've been looking at this situation trying to see how I can get the positives in it, and I already viewed myself as a wild card for this cast, so being an underdog, totally a part of that. So I kind of already expected that the cast wasn't gonna be expecting a ton from me based on, you know, what I have on my social media up until this point. So they don't know what I can do. So I'm using that to my advantage. So going into this challenge, I wanted to harness that. And this was already the challenge that I was really focusing on.
I'm happy to see another day. Like, if it's my moment, it's my moment to shine. If it's my moment to fall, it's my moment to fall. Like, but as long as I'm satisfied with what I did in a round, that's what I'm living with. Like, so far I haven't been like, oh wow, I'm so disappointed in myself.
Jesus, I don't know. I stopped believing in Jesus when I was in college, and I'm not gonna start now.
I'm just still waiting for my high placement in this competition, so a little bit
But I think there's honestly probably the most pressure on Anastasia, because everybody was like, bitch, you're the spooky girl, do the spooky thing, and she's been not doing great, like bottom two times in a row, which sucks because that's my girl, that's my sister, to an extent.
I had an idea of how I would do, and so far, I have not met that idea at all.
I was not shocked by September 5th getting that advantage. It was deserved after they put Dom last to choose their Katy Perry song. None of us were gagged, really. It was like, yeah, I would have been gagged if Dom chose anybody else.
A couple people asked me, like, did you consider giving anyone else the disadvantage? And I was just like, no, there would be no reason to.
I expected this. Yeah, I mean, I would. It's a spooky challenge, and I'm a relatively spooky entertainer, and I have the best track record aside from himself. It's the smartest decision to give the disadvantage back to me.
And now it's even.
So after last week, when the whole thing with October like actually started, it wasn't like a group chat thing. It was just Anastasia had DM'd me saying, hey, October said this about you after you left the voice call, which I was like, okay, thank you, Anastasia. Love you, sister. Then a couple days later, it ended up being brought up in the group chat. Anastasia was like alluding to my situation with October. And I just don't like being in the room where people are talking about me and I'm not talking. And so I said, first of all, I'm gonna clock the tea because I don't give a tuck. And I said, October, why are you mad? Like a bitch from West Bumfuck. Cause they were so hung up about, oh, it just seems like you can't take critiques and I just like won't say my opinion anymore. It was like, no, it wasn't that. It was the fact that it wasn't a space where I was asking for advice or for people's thoughts on anything. People were just asking me how I felt, and I said I felt good. And then you felt the need to unmute yourself from what you were doing and then tell me something you didn't like about it, which was weird. That's what confessionals are for, bitch. You say all the shit that you don't want to say to people's faces here.
I felt October was being two-faced with things that were being asked of them in VCs when certain people were there, and then they would either have said something before that was completely contradictory to what they had just said, or they would wait for that person to leave and then say something. And I think October probably might feel a type of way about me specifically because they said in the chat that they said to me in confidence. And I was like, you didn't tell me not to say anything. anything to anybody else. You didn't tell me to keep a secret. You never sworn me to secrecy. You waited until AJ left to then try to dog on AJ. And I didn't like that. So yes, I went and told them and I gave them the receipts and everything too. It's not my fault you got caught.
I feel like there's certain cliques, you know, certain people are close to other people, but I feel like today specifically, there's been some cracks and some interesting tea that I found out today that will probably be addressed later regarding October, because October is kind of two-faced, and I'm just glad that more people are seeing that now. Today in the VC, we were all in the call keying about the music videos, and I'd say I was in there about maybe like hour and a half or whatever, just keying with Anastasia in October. They were in there before me, and apparently when October left, Anastasia told me, well, October's playing games. And I was like, well, girl, what do you mean? Well, she said that October told her that she thinks that me and Anastasia are gonna be in the bottom again this week. And I was like, that's interesting, because I've been here on the call the whole time. We've been talking about placements, and that bitch did not say that to me or anything regarding that. She actually praised me. So it's crazy for her to be like that, I guess. I was like, that just kind of threw me off. And then when October came back to the chat later and I asked them about their bottom two placements, it's, oh, well, I have a bottom five. You know, it was a whole lot of ums and ohs, and bitch, stop dancing around the question. Like, if either you said it or you didn't or whatever, just tell me that part.
I just woke up today and all of a sudden my name is being thrown in the chat in some like indirect shady way. And I was like, huh? I wake up and they're talking about the power up in the chat, and Dantasia's like, I'm not worried about anyone using a disadvantage on me unless July 4th wins the challenge, but they actually don't see me as competition, so maybe I don't actually have anything to worry about. I'm like, girl, I just woke up. I wasn't saying anything shady, and now you're just like bringing me into this conversation where I feel like now I have to like defend my case. It's so weird. I don't know, I felt like this narrative was being spun for me, and she was trying to say like, I was talking shit behind her back, which like isn't necessarily true. I was talking with Anastasia about placements, and I said who I possibly think could be where, and they were like very vague placements, and I really only have confidence in who I think will be like a high four or a top four, and like everything below that, I was like, I don't know, but I like low-key had feelings, and just generally about the music video, like Anna and Dantasia would be in the bottom too. And I told Anna that, and I told her all the reasons that I thought that, and I gave her constructive criticism on her video, and then later I also gave constructive criticism for Dantasia's video. But after that, Anastasia went and told Dantasia that I thought that she was bottom too. And I was like, what the fuck, girl? Dantasia's like, I don't know why you expected Anastasia, who's my best friend, to keep something from me that you said about me. And thinking about that more, I think that that is absolutely hilarious, because Dantasia told Anastasia that Jesus didn't like their look, and then it became an issue. But nobody had an issue with Dantasia saying that. Dantasia told David that Anastasia had an issue with his music video, but nobody had an issue with Dantasia saying that. But now all of a sudden, I'm confused.
There's a current fight that's happening right now, and I think the core of it is October doesn't treat people that they think are bad at drag as valuable people, because right now October is saying that they don't think that AJ and Anna were giving this week, and from how October has been treating me and Dantasia and the other people who they aren't necessarily friends with but they think is bad at drag, they're like, wait, now do you have problems with me because it's the same moment? It was four people who were mad at October, and they should have all individually handled that instead of piling on. Like, whenever I was jumping in, it wasn't to necessarily defend October and like that. I was just like, hey, if we're gonna share opinions, it's gotta be okay to share opinions. And everyone else is kind of mad about different things.
A lot of people are just seeing October in different lights because they act different depending on who's in the call and who they're talking to. And honestly, I think I've seen it from the beginning when I was first like not feeling their vibe. And then we were chilling and I got to know them more and I was like, okay, maybe I just didn't understand where they were coming from and their approaches with things and sure. And then they basically let me have the song I wanted this week, okay. But then that came up and I was like, oh no, here we go. That's the bitch that like, I thought they were.
I think that October's attitude and all the things have been rubbing people the wrong way. It just now is rubbing the people who they've been closest to in the competition the wrong way. So that's just what's happening.
AJ and Orbit specifically have this like energy of immaturity in like coming for someone just because maybe their feelings are hurt. Like Orbit popped out of season one out of nowhere just to like defend her sister, I guess, and say that I have a shitty personality and subpar drag. And I was like, girl, what? How is this? I just don't understand or at all relate to the sentiment that like you need to be tearing people down just because you're upset. Like that is so far from being productive towards like addressing the situation at hand. Like if there's an issue, I'm open to talk about it, but this isn't how we're gonna talk about it. Like at this point, if you have an issue with me, if it's not being presented to me in a conversation that I can like actually be an adult and participate in, like I'm just not entertaining it.
We had a discussion about that and I asked them, I was like, well, do you dislike me? And they were like, I don't. And I was like, well, despite my feelings last week, because that was really my feelings last week about October, I was like, the feeling's mutual. So we're okay. Apparently their rival is AJ, whatever that's about. That bitch still gets on my nerves. I still really care for the attitude, but like we're okay.
Anastasia was like public enemy number one as soon as this started, and now it feels like everybody has switched from disliking her to at the very least like tolerating her. I like her. I enjoy her more when she's in a one-on-one. I think in a group setting she turns it on like fiercely and it can make her seem a little disingenuous, but in a one-on-one setting she's really nice. She helped me through a lot this week.
I don't know if they're understanding her, but they are sympathizing with her because of how she's been doing in the competition. I think everybody's warming up to her more, but like understanding her and where she comes from, I still don't think so yet.
It just feels like people don't really like October, which as somebody that doesn't like October, I'm okay with.
I definitely feel a bit misunderstood. Yeah, I don't know. I think a lot of people have expectations and like needs or wants in regard to like communication with each other, and I don't think that all of those needs and wants have been clearly communicated, and I think a lot of people are misunderstanding each other. Now I'm just like, okay, it's competition, let's get focused and just handle the things that I need to handle.
For this week's side quest, we were inspired by a different horror movie franchise, Scream. We want our warriors to deliver the most gut-wrenching, guttural scream that they can muster. And you at home will be voting for the winner. Let's watch.
Oh! first question to you is, how did it feel being safe?
Ooh, I got an email from Boulay Brothers Production. Did I get on season 6? I didn't make it.
It's me, AJ Knox, coming out with another video. I just got this new wig recently. Isn't she gorge? Anyways, I'm so happy I finally have a style like this because I'm... My wig!
Oh, you want to be my friend?
Yeah, it's hard. It's hard being extremely wealthy. I know. And then I said, no thanks, Dad. 2 yachts is plenty. Oh, hold on. I'm getting a text message. Bitcoin dropped by 90%?
Linked down below is a Google form where you can vote for the winner of this week's side quest. And the winner will get a $25 cash prize.
Now let's look at how our cast prepared for this challenge. And knowing them, the drama could give us all a fright.
Do I like spooky shit? Hell yeah, I like spooky shit. What the fuck? Like, it's a part of my brand. It's the 3 S's. Silly, spooky, sexy.
Halloween is my favorite holiday. I love watching, like, from the start of September until honestly a few days into November. I am just all Halloween mode. The only things I will watch are things that I deem as either like Halloween or Halloween adjacent.
I love spooky shit. Halloween just, it smooths out certain crevices in my brain where I can just go, which I feel like is very evident in my aesthetic. I do like to be on the darker side of things. It makes me feel empowered. It makes me feel like a badass bitch. And it makes it feel like no one can fuck with me. Because if they do, I'll rip their throats out.
I fucking love spooky shit. Okay, actually, I'm gonna backpedal on most of what I just said because I actually don't like a lot of horror movies. Because I don't like to be scared, okay? I don't like to be scared.
Well, I'm not a big fan of horror movies. When it comes to paranormal things, I'm not the person for paranormal shit. I cannot sleep sometimes for days after watching something like Conjuring or Insidious. I'm scared. And when I see people doing tarot cards or something like that, I'm always telling them, please, you'll conjure something. Don't do that. Don't play with the devil.
I like witchy shit. I'm into like tarot. I'm into the witchy stuff. I love the craft. I love practical magic. I love Coraline. I like eerie things. I like some goth stuff, but I don't like gore. I don't like violence. I don't like blood and guts. I don't like Final Destination.
I do not like spooky shit. I do not like horror at all. It's like so not me. Actually, the more I think about it, the more I'm like, this is probably the worst challenge for me. If I watch it, it just puts this like scary, negative, like fearful, nervous energy into my brain. And then I hold that in my brain and then I go out into the real world and I'm like, like jumping because a grandma walked around the corner and I thought she was a demon or something.
Queer people love horror so much. I think overall because we know what it's like to be like the outsiders. And so like sometimes we root for the villains when it's necessary.
A lot of horror like villains and stuff were queer coded because they wanted to kind of inspire fear in the general public of anything that was remotely queer.
Life is kind of scary as a queer person, and it's nice to be able to get scared by things that aren't related to the lifestyle that you live. Queer people potentially gravitate towards Halloween because, I mean, it's called Gay Christmas, like within the queer space, but Christmas can be a source of contention, or, you know, even Thanksgiving, like holidays where families get together, especially that have a religious connotation, can definitely have a stigma to queer people who have been potentially disowned by their families or aren't on great terms with their families.
I think queer people connect with horror really because we go through life with the reality in our head that any day could be a day where we run into someone who, because of their belief system, decides that your life is not valid and shouldn't exist. So we go through life in public knowing that and having to, you know, potentially keep up these barriers. You know, there's this whole idea of like code switching, like that's something that we have to do to keep ourselves safe. So knowing that there's horror in reality, watching it and being able to sort of poke fun at it, or at the very least sort of, you know, have a release where you're accepting it. It's scaring you, but it's happening to somebody else. I don't know, it's like a Schadenfreude sort of thing.
In terms of the challenge, I am a big fan of the franchise.
I was really excited for Horror Week. Script writing and storyboarding is something that, you know, I studied. I really, like, that's something I know is a skill of mine. And then to find out that we were going to do it within sort of this, like, horror realm was so exciting. I wanted to eat up this episode.
I knew going into this challenge that I was going to be under scrutiny because I do classify myself as a drag monster. I was even told that in the critiques, they were expecting big things from me this week. So that, paired with a lot of my fellow warriors also saying that they expected me to make a giant turnaround and possibly even win this challenge. Whew! That's a lot of pressure.
I actually have seen the Final Destination movies. They're one of my favorite movie series.
The second one is my favorite one. It's the first one I watched. I was just obsessed. I've watched them all. I know a lot of like facts and everything. And me and Anastasia were talking about the challenge and everything. And she was like, well, they do this, this, and that. And I was like, well, girl, they do all this stuff. She's like, girl, I didn't know that. I was like, well, girl, I know this stuff about this movie, so.
Final Destination, there's some deaths in those, and there's some themes in those movies that have scarred certain parts of our generation. Like, if I'm in a car that gets behind a log truck, I am noping, I am shaking my head, I am pulling the seatbelt, I am kicking the back seat.
Never been in a tanning bed, never will.
I'm afraid of driving over train tracks now because of Final Destination specifically.
Walking past construction sites, things able to fall.
Fireworks and like getting impaled and getting like smashed by something.
Oh my God, the pool drain, getting caught in the pool drain and drowning.
I can't recreate that without hurting myself. And I don't have the video editing skills to like blow myself up without it looking like trash.
I was so excited to like poke fun at this franchise because it's something that has stuck with me throughout my whole life.
I don't know. I know that some people are gonna go campy, stupid. I know some people are gonna go like gory and like serious. And some people are gonna, don't know. David's gonna do what David does.
So, some things were definitely going down for this week for me, which, you know, I have to be spooky, I have to be scary, I have to be on top of my game. And I had a seizure that led to me passing out. I ended up being bed rested for 2 days after that. And until I did the runway, I thought I was going to be in the bottom again. And then the night I did the runway, I don't know what happened. But after filming all the stuff for that, it just lit a fire under my ass. I was like, no, this is not how I'm going to go out. I can't go out crying. I can't be down on myself. This is not me. I am usually the one that's giving people the advice they need to uplift themselves. Why can't I do that for myself? And with help remembering that, as well as with my partner Ty helping me through it, I think I definitely overcame everything. I can only prepare so much, because then life is just going to throw stuff at you that you're not going to be prepared for. Especially having something like epilepsy, where you don't really get a warning. I mean, like, I'll get the feeling, like, right before it happens, but, like, you don't get, like, the morning you wake up, like, oh, today's going to be a seizure day. You don't get those kind of warnings. After all that was said and done, everything was settled, everything was gotten over, I had 3 days. Out of the 2 weeks that we were supposed to have, I only had 3 days to really work on anything. Luckily, I was already preparing my runway beforehand. So that, for the most part, was done. It was the video that I needed to make sure was golden, because they didn't like my editing last time, and they felt like they could see me thinking last time. Which, this time, since I chose a character who thinking, that's not her strength.
Me and Anastasia decided to work together. It was very last minute. Like, the day of me filming and she was about to start filming hers, I was just telling her my idea, and I was already in my video. I'm like on the phone with like my homegirl or whatever, and at the last moment, like, we were just like, we should connect ours. It'd be funny, it'd be cute, it'd be kind of a gag, and nobody else is gonna do it.
And we're linking ours in the same universe, which also means that it's gonna actually feel like the films. And honestly, working with Dantasia has been immensely fun. Like, we both really loved this movie franchise, and we both came up with really good ideas, and we combined them so well. Like, it was fun filming this.
She's genuinely just, like, my best friend. And, like, we were in this, like, together. So, even though this wasn't, like, a team challenge, we, like, kind of made it that. But we're going to see how it shakes down.
My approach going into this challenge was to try and stand out. I definitely think that spooky shit is something that I do well. And I wanted to try to secure a win this week, honestly. I mean, not that I'm not trying to secure a win every week, but this kind of had my name written all over it in a sense. So for my runway in particular, I wanted to make myself stand out by creating a character in the movie that I chose, which is Coraline. I know that Coraline looks like the other mother can be popular and something, I don't want to say overdone, but I have seen a lot of Coraline looks. So instead of doing something inspired by the other mother, I wanted to make my own character.
And I'm creating a character in the Coraline universe that is called the Button Master. The Button Master is the bitch that gives the Beldam her buttons. You know, it's a business deal. It's a transaction. She's a businesswoman. Buttons be getting sewn into eyes. All shapes, all sizes, and these buttons, baby, are they burning the fuck out of my finger? Absolutely. Is my cat licking the fuck out of his paw in the background? Absolutely. So here I am adding hot glue all over these gloves that I have made for this runway to kind of give it some texture and add an additional creepy factor. I didn't want to go overload with the buttons. I mean, I already kind of did. So this is what I'm doing. I'm going to paint over the hot glue to make it look more seamless. But yes, I did burn the ever-loving fuck out of my fingers making this.
I have been loving putting all this together, but I think the stress is just getting to me right now. I'm a little in my head. I just got done talking with Derek, who has been super wonderful, but it's like every one of my concepts, there's like one thing that needs to be changed for the video to like make it Final Destination. And like, I don't know, I feel like I keep hitting a little mental roadblock with this. And I'm just hoping that the challenge goes well for me this week, because I've been putting in a lot of work again, and I don't know, the stress is a lot, but I am confident that after one more rewrite of my script, that hopefully, fingers crossed, we should be in Final Destination land. So wish me luck. I have been paying a lot of attention to what I say in the chat, who is friends in the chat, and honestly, I have been playing it very, very safe, because I know that someone, if they see me as one, a cunt, or two, a threat, they can cut my ass off in whatever way they want, you know, or whatever way they obtain that week. I'm trying to make sure I'm friends with everybody, and if I have beef with anybody in the chat because I have a big mouth, I'm trying to squash it. I don't know, I'm not trying to form an enemy with anyone. I'm not trying to make anyone have any reason to dislike me and want to use an advantage against me. I kind of have the mindset and strategy of, I'm just being a nice, sweet cup of chai, and hopefully everyone likes what they're tasting, because I would not like to have someone use an advantage against me, especially because of something my big fat mouth said. So
okay, y'all, so I have like 4 days to get everything complete. So right now I am, where to go, I'm kind of a hot mess. Like, I got in my head this challenge. Like, I was very much listening to the judges' critiques and kind of warping it in my head. Also, I've just been like sad, like depressed, whatever. So this is like the core of the goblin demon's belly. And then I have these flaps that I'm gonna sew on, and really, I think that it's gonna give like reveal to like maybe some guts or something, like something's gonna fall out of it. But then when I actually like made the outfit halfway, I wanna say I made it like 65% of the way, I was like, this is ugly. Okay. This is ugly. And a lot of different ideas. I like the, it's ugly. Like, I know even if I spend the rest of the time like changing the outfit around or whatever, it's ugly. I have like 2 days to change things around. I'm also editing. I will be embarrassed if I went home on a horror challenge. Being like a spooky girl, I think it was like the pressure in my head, like, oh, you have to be the spooky, ookiest, ookiest. So I had that pressure in my head. So I'm starting over.
I'm about to shoot my Final Destination video, and look at my incredibly professional setup. We have lamps on top of boxes, on top of dresses. Professional. And the professionalism continues, because my tripod broke the other day, so I've managed to fix it by hot gluing this ruler to that side. I feel like MacGyver / my life is falling apart, and so are all of my belongings. I've just finished my Final Destination death video, which I'm very excited about. His sponge with the little dead eyes and my green screen. I love it, but I'm a little bit nervous because it's very similar to my music video, which I also really loved, and then everybody else hated it and I was in the bottom. But I really loved it. This is very much a similar vibe. Like, it's green screen again. It's a similar character. So we'll see. Maybe this time they'll like it, but I just wanted to make something that was me, and this is very me.
So going into the main challenge for this next round, I'm feeling good. Not great, I'm not gonna lie, but good. You know, obviously it's a little frustrating to be safe two times in a row. But the nice thing is that with Drag Duel, I've been getting critiques even though I've been safe. So, you know, I have been receiving feedback on things I could be working on. So I'm happy about the feedback I got from this last round. Obviously, I thought I was going to be on the top. That didn't happen. This round, I don't want my confidence to be shaken, but at the same time, I don't need another Jan face crack sort of moment where I'm going in hot and then I find out that I'm apparently just mid. But I'm feeling really good about my idea. I'm showcasing my fun, flirty, slutty side. My video is just gonna be stupid. And honestly, one of my favorite compliments to get after a performance is for somebody to come up to me and be like, "That was stupid." 'Cause a lot of my numbers are just, I try to find where I can just insert the humor and the absurdity and poke fun at it. And I really hope that you all enjoy my absurd 2 minutes. So this is my stunt double, Helena Toy. And she's got a new hole, just like her mother. Yeah, I don't know if she'll be able to act again. Her acting career might be over with. But I love that her breasts were the last thing to go. I mean, she really is part of my family. And that's it. There's no one else to thank. No one else was in my film. It was a one-woman show.
Oh my God, this challenge. I knew it was gonna be editing. I knew it was gonna be things flying in the air and quick little clips that were gonna need to be edited with sound effects and to make it almost like cartoonish. And that was the detail-oriented stuff that I was dreading putting together. And then on top of that, in my genius brain, I thought it would be a good idea to learn how to animate over video footage, something I've never done before. And I thought, I'll just do that. Like, that'll be easy. That will be the easy way to accomplish this. And I learned real quick that that was probably a bad idea. My understanding is that this challenge is about making a special effect happen. It's about making a death happen. We all know they're over the top. It's not easy to do any kind of special effect. That's why they're special. I don't know if I need the 3 minutes for this challenge, but I certainly could use like an extra day. I don't know if anyone else is struggling with this challenge. I could see this being a problem from a mile away, and I just feel like nobody else like was as nervous about it as me.
Hi. Yeah. I just want to fill you in on the process here for animation. Animation is hard. Do you think that I really thought it through? Do you think I really, really thought it through? Or do you think it was a situation where Dom Perignon was just like, sure, I can do that. And I was like, I'll just figure it out on the fly and I'll figure it out and it'll be fine and it'll just happen. Let me just show you.
All right, so in this handy dandy little iPad app, I've got this liquor bottle, I've got this liquor on the floor, and like in, I don't know, 5 seconds, I'm just trying to show that there is a big spill, okay? Sounds easy. I'm like, oh, I can just, you know, copy and paste every single frame. But no. Because every time the camera moves, the liquor in the bottle has to move with it. That's just the liquor in the bottle, which of course I picked two colors to... Okay, anyways. Every single frame, and it's 12 frames per second, has to follow the shape of the bottle. And I haven't even gotten to the spill on the floor. And I've been doing this for like an hour. This is for about 5 to 10 seconds of footage. It's gonna be fine.
The judges told us, film your final destination movie. Make it gory. Make it a death. Don't actually hurt yourself. I was not expecting carpal tunnel on my bingo card this year.
You know, the way I roll is just like, I got an idea and there's no time and I just gotta go. Like, I just gotta go for it and just like hope that it works. So...
Oh my God, these warriors are a scary bunch. But maybe it is time for some of them to die.
Now everybody grab your popcorn and swerve out of any lane that has a log truck in it. The premiere of Final Destination 6, The Death of Drag, is about to start.
As always, our warriors' tipping info will be on screen during their performance. So tip these warriors!
Breaking news, a fire broke out at a local nightclub and left hundreds dead. We're on site with a witness who saw it all.
What's behind me used to be a nightclub, but now it's just a burning hole in the ground. Everyone died, and the only thing left is this flag. However, just before everything started, I was standing outside. I was just having a pack, and can I say this? Can I say this on TV? Okay. I was smoking, and I saw 9 people and a sponge leave minutes before it all happened. All I want to say is, they are the luckiest 9 people and a sponge in this world.
I left my LimeWire on again. Fuck yeah, on my way, honey. Heart.
PK, drive safe, sexy. Awesome.
When'd you leave?
I'll be back in 1 second.
Ow. Okay.
When I got married, I married a Bette Davis. But the older she gets, the more I feel like I'm married to Milton Berle.
This guy's gone way over his time.
Not to mention no one's laughing.
Having a wife is like having a car. They take you where you want to go, they both have a solid body, and they're not cheap to maintain.
Last train's in 10 minutes. Think I should pull the plug?
Last time we cut his time, he reamed us out to the producers. If you need to head home, I say just go for it.
All right. I'm leaving the board on.
Now hold on, hold on. I love my wife. She's sweet, she's well-read. Oh, did I say well-read? I meant good in bed. She's always complaining I don't plan enough dates. Well, I'm planning a date all right. The day I am finally...
Tell his wife he's not gonna make the train.
Uh-huh. Yeah, I'll be leaving my house in like 5 minutes. I think that's when the Uber's picking me up. I just need to fix my lipstick and touch my hair up. Speaking of my fucking hair, bitch. Oh my god, did you see what my publicist just made me do? I know that blonde to black is a little bit severe. I don't know if my fans are even gonna recognize me. Girl, I need to call you back. I think the fucking power just went out or something.
Welcome, my beautiful little dinosaur, into another land of adventure. The only little things that I don't like are little tips. The fun loves you.
I'm Jason Puck the Sponge. My owner Tony bought me from the dollar store a year ago, and he hasn't even used me. He's never even cooked a day in his life. This sponge is gonna live forever. Alright, there goes Tony now, having another Chinese takeaway, Tony. What's that? What's that coming out the tap? Ah, it's hot, 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 hot. Ooh, it's burning me. Oh, I don't like it. Tony, no, not the carrot peeler. You don't need to peel a carrot. You can just order Uber Eats again. It's sharp. Sharp against the spongy skin. Tony, what are you doing? No, not the trash, Tony. You can use a sponge more than one time. Tony, no. Oh no, where am I? What's that voice? It's Dumpster Diving Drag Queens! Oh! No, Monet, use the fabric, please! You don't need the sponge! You don't need it! No!
I'm literally cleaning the floor with my garment as I'm walking down the runway, and it's fucking fierce.
I'm sorry, on the sponges with the lip, right? Give me my 10 for my sponges. 10s across the board.
Didn't like this session, girl. Dr. Derek really set me up.
Yes, girl. Make that money, honey. You know, I've been thinking how crazy it is that we survived that bus incident.
Girl, if it wasn't for us giving those semi-attractive jocks head, it would have been our heads, bitch.
Yeah, you're so...
Huh? Sarah?
Vicky? Hello?
Oh, I guess the call dropped. That bitch should have paid her bill. Anyway. Ooh, bitch, girl, this is spicy. Ooh.
Thank you.
my apprentice Giggles. We're the clowns to turn any frown upside down. For my first bit, I'll need a volunteer. All right, yes, you. Pick a card. Any card, but don't show me. Oh, sorry, wrong deck.
Is it in yet? Oh, sorry, Anastasia. Someone more important is calling. Hi, Daddy Dong.
Yes, sir. I just need to finish my breakfast and clean out my ass.
It's good enough for Jesus. It's good enough for me.
Don't need it anyway. October gets by without theirs.
Oh, I forgot to do laundry. Smells like Bujo's personality. No one will notice.
No. What am I, David Puck?
Driverless car arriving. Calibrating. Calibrating. Calibrating.
Oh my god, this thing moves like AJ's runway walk. Huh.
Driverless car departing.
Fuck my tuck. I haven't felt something that bumpy since Chai's padding.
Oh wait, she doesn't pad.
Hi, Daddy.
I wouldn't have it. Boot.
Maybe Dontasia's still up. Oh, there's my phone. Oh, and it's already calling me a car.
Lana, I just saw my own death while I was gagging on your...
Trey did like the session, girl. Dr. Derek really set me up.
Yes, girl. Make that money, honey. You know, I've been thinking how crazy it is that we survived that bus incident.
Girl, if it wasn't for us giving those semi-attractive jocks head, it would have been our heads, bitch.
Yeah, you're so...
Huh? Sarah?
Vicky? Hello? What the hell? I just paid this damn phone bill. What fucking good are you if you ain't gonna work?
Sergio, can you help me with the long furniture?
Yes, Ma. I'm coming out. I'll help you with the damn long furniture. Don't know why Rudd can't do any damn thing. Ooh. Text Vicky. Stay away from fire, girl. Don't go near no open flame. Watch out for the synthetic units. Oh no. Why did I have to be the one to get stuck with the damn visions? Why couldn't it be somebody else who has some kind of degree or some shit? Oh. And Brud, you better keep that damn football over there. I swear to God, if you hit me with it, I'm gonna kill you. Oh.
Well, I guess the ground is just a little too soft over here.
It's up there, bro.
Oh my god, I hope they are okay. The Warriors really killed it in this challenge. But now it is time for the runway. This week category is Scary Movie.
So for this runway, I really wanted to go like Killer Robot-esque. I have my x-ray showing my human parts that I run on. It's very Ex Machina, it's very We Appreciate Power, very 1980s Chrome Woman art. I just look good. And this wig is amazing, thank you, Orbit.
Did you make my reservation at Dorsia? If not, you're shit out of luck, because in this look, I'm channeling Patrick Bateman from American Psycho. I'm mixing axe murderer with sociopathic wealth in this blood-stained head-to-toe look. Oh, and my recipe for fake blood? Well, that's a serial killer's best-kept secret.
Inspired by everybody's first horror film and one of my favorites, Coraline, I wanted to create a character in the Coraline universe called the Button Master, who makes sure that creatures like the Beldum get buttons to sew into everybody's eyes. After hours of hot gluing, so much hard work sewing paper into fabric, here she is.
This runway is inspired by goblins, ghouls, and everything that goes bump in the night. I made everything but the boots and the bodysuit.
My scary movie look is inspired by the amazing art of Tim Burton. I always loved small animals like lizards, snakes, and spiders, and they were always my pet toys. I wanted to create a human-like spider character that could be part of the Corpse Bride story. The shape of my spider eyes that are made of little black pearls is inspired by Dr. Finkelstein's glasses. I love how weird and eerie this look turned out.
My scary movie runway is inspired by the mother and other mother from Coraline. Aesthetically, mine is based on my actual mum with her coiffed brunette hair. Her eyes turn to buttons and her smile becomes large and scarily disingenuous.
Liquor, I hardly know her. Baby, this week on the runway for the scary movie runway, I wanted to pay homage to one of my favorite horror series, Resident Evil. And I was like, girl, what Resident Evil? Bitch, a creature. What other than the liquor? But you know, make her cunty and give her body, that part.
For my scary movie runway, I created a Victorian witch that was chased through the woods and killed by fire. She's been dead for centuries, but she's crawled out from the earth to seek her revenge. This look is two pieces that I assembled and distressed using black tea, hot cocoa, acrylic paints, steel wool, and fire.
Better pay the toll. Or Karen, the fairy them of Hades,
will never take you across the River Styx. The number one rule of a drag show is that you better tip a bitch. Otherwise, your soul will be forever damned to wander hell, and the only thing available to watch are drag detective videos.
They say to love the skin that you're in, but I love the feeling of everyone's skin, which is why I wear it so well. Inspired by Leatherface, Wrong Turn, and Sleepaway Camp, this is a homage to the good old Southern horror comforts.
As a horror super fan, I was not let down this week. You all delivered.
And again, before we begin with our critiques, just remember, these are opinions of three randos that you see on your screen. They do not define your drag. However, we have made some decisions.
I'm really nervous, sir. I'm like shaking right now. I just don't know what is about to happen. I have no idea. Everyone I've talked to has said the same thing. Like, nobody knows how this is gonna shake out. And I just don't know.
Dom Perignon.
I'm too fragile for this.
Chai and Anastasia Page Milano. You three are safe.
I'm safe.
Ah! Okay, good. Ah!
What the fuck is that?
Chai, we just want to say that you had one of our favorite runways this week. That look was truly amazing. We just wanted to acknowledge it.
I'm surprised that Chai is safe. The other two kind of make sense. Anastasia giving safe as per usual.
Now, if I have not called your name, that means that you are either a top or a bottom lacing warrior. And to help us make our final decision, please welcome back a stud from season one of Drag Duel. It's Tyler Knoll!
Hi!
Tyler, this look is iconic. I had a nightmare last night and it looked a lot like this look.
Thank you. Was it a nightmare where you looked skinny for once? Sorry.
It's not the roast episode yet.
Sorry. Wait.
So, let us start off with AJ Knox. Tyler, what did you think about AJ's Final Destination video?
I love AJ. I thought that they had a lot of creativity and interesting vibes going on, but I feel like the film work itself was a little bit confusing because I didn't quite understand what had happened until I watched it a second time. And I was a little bit like, wait, what happened to her? Like, why is she bleeding? And I loved her stupid, like, monologue while she's waiting to get killed.
Yeah, I feel like AJ found a great way to mix her kind of vibe and her humor with this challenge. I thought the character was great, the characterization was fun. I love the soundtrack choices. And for the runway, this was really creepy. Like, it was giving kind of, like, Uncanny Valley.
AJ's runway was really creepy. It was really sexy as well. I am a really big sci-fi fan, so I loved seeing somebody do, like, some sci-fi horror, creepy, sexy robot lady. Like, I would fuck her.
Up next, we have Jesus Vice. Going into this week, I was so excited for what Jesus was going to bring. This is definitely their bread and butter, but I was a little bit let down, especially with their video. Like, it was so bizarre. It was a lot to, like, take in, and I feel like they had 30 extra seconds that they did not use. I think that they definitely would have benefited from using more and fleshing out who these people were and what was going on.
There wasn't really too many Final Destination-esque moments, but overall compared to others, it just didn't stand out.
I don't know, I can't help that I enjoyed it, that I thought was like really weird and stupid. I could see the effort that was put in. I loved that, like, you know, that fucking Uno card eyeball prosthetic thing was great. I think it was like so nonsense that I just I kind of liked it.
And on the runway, I just found the look a little bit confusing. I wasn't really sure what was happening or what the idea was.
I really liked this runway, but it was definitely a little bit confusing. I know that they said that it was a goblin thing. It was an amalgamation of all the monsters. And I kind of wish that Jesus just stuck with one monster or one kind of idea of what a monster could be, because I could not decipher what it was.
If I was doing this runway, I would change a lot, and I just didn't get the vision, unfortunately. I love Jesus's creativity, but the execution just wasn't it for this runway.
Many of these runways were disappointing to me, so I personally enjoyed Jesus's runway because I thought it was like, it was doing something.
Up next, we have Lana V, who is another person who really surprised me. I wasn't sure where her drag would meet this prompt and this kind of theme for this week, but she did a really, really good job. Her Final Destination video was so funny.
I was so pleasantly surprised. Lana's video made me laugh, and it had levels. I really wasn't sure how the stripper was gonna die.
I thought that her acting was good. I liked that she really didn't need to say much for us to know exactly who her character was. And it really just felt like a natural scene from a Final Destination movie. I loved the chatterbait porn music, which was so funny. I was cackling.
It was creative and fun, and I liked that she got to show off her pole skills too. I don't know if we were meant to be able to hear her audio, her like speaking in that scene, but we couldn't. And it was a little bit distracting because I couldn't tell if I was supposed to hear it or not.
And on the runway, Lana presented Spook. It was a big silhouette. It was a big scary spider. I really liked the attention to detail. One thing I maybe would do if I was doing this challenge, I would love to see like little toy spiders put on a little white string, and then it looks like they are crawling on you. You can just sew them on the bodysuit, so it's like a fringe, gives you movement, but it looks scary and spooky.
The makeup was fantastic. The way she performed it was fantastic. I thought maybe she could have put something on like the belly of the spider just to break up some of the black, because it was a lot of black fabric.
It was something totally different from the rest of the stuff we were seeing on the runway, and I love to see like a big concept, but I agree that it needed some kind of depth. It was like all black. It needed some detail.
Okay, up next we have David Puck. Now, David's Final Destination video, did I laugh? Yes. Did I have fun? Yes. Was it camp? Yes. Was it Final Destination? No.
I really liked David's idea. I think David's sponge was funny, and the idea of the sponge going through so many things. How can a sponge die just to end up on Monet Exchange? I think that was genius, and I really love what David did this week. I know it's polarizing. I know the two of you don't agree with me, but for me, I really liked what David presented.
Both David and Dom are not horror fans. They were not looking forward to this week, but I think that Dom was able to kind of bridge the gap between his drag and what we were asking more than David was, and was more willing to like play ball with what we really wanted from this week.
Immediately upon finishing watching his, I thought of like six ideas that would have been amazing and within the realm of Final Destination that I wish that he had done. Like, imagine if he had been an object from the Final Destination universe. For instance, like David Puck as a log, and then he gets killed by going through somebody's back windshield and like killing them. Like, that would have been so good.
Now for David's runway, this is the second Coraline inspired look that we saw on this runway, and unfortunately this wasn't my favorite version. I really like it. I think David took critiques. There were heels. However, when I compare it to Chai's, I wish David also took more attention to those details.
But I just wanted scary. I want to see, what does David Puck scary look like? And this just felt silly.
Yeah, and I think you can do silly scary. And he could totally do silly scary, like a campy horror look. Would have been right up his alley, I think, but I don't think he did a horror look at all.
So up next, we have Dontasia DeBatty.
Yeah, I'm really loving what I've seen from Dontasia, and I think that she has like a huge amount of potential. But I don't think the other contestants are seeing that. I think that she's being underestimated a little bit. And I know I've seen in the group chats that maybe she's feeling some type of way about it.
Yeah, I feel like Dantasia's personality shone through so well in this. And she knew the source material, which was really great because it seems like a lot of other people did not understand the source material.
Her death itself was like really, really cool. I loved how like she had the special effects. And then of course she like brought in the hot stuff music, like slowly coming in, like it was so like on point and camp.
Which is another Easter egg from Final Destination, because they'll use like Love Roller Coaster, or there's someone walking behind you to be like, hey, it's a little music cue and you have to pay attention because it's going to tell you what's going to happen next. Like that was really cute.
Now on the runway, I do like the final look. However, I know where I can go and get that same look myself. So because of that, I do have to take some points off just compared to everybody else and all the custom creations we saw on the runway.
But I still think it was camp enough, like seeing this like liquor with like body and she's working it and she's giving like sass and fun. It was funny enough that I really didn't mind that it was like a bunch of separates. I do wish that she stoned the bodysuit. Up next, we have Helena Boy. Butsy, what did you think about Helena's video?
Helena's video was hilarious. Helena really hit all the right spots. So many fake outs. The video was so referential. She did her own little reading challenge during this video, and I think that was amazing.
Helena found the perfect balance of her comedy, her humor, her perspective, and what Final Destination is. There were those red herrings of like, is she gonna die like this with the douche in the bathroom? Is she gonna die getting hit by this car? Like, there's so many different things falling down the stairs.
She had my favorite video. I think she had a very clear idea and she executed it well. She executed it in like a concise manner. I think a lot of the other videos dragged on in weird spots where I was like, why are we still looking at this? We don't need this.
And then for the runway, doing this troll that comes and gets you if you don't tip your local queens and kings is so funny. This boat is giving elevation. Mm-hmm. I mean, there's so many details that went into this.
I think Helena is another one who listens to our critiques and she elevated, and I think she did a fabulous job this week.
The idea, the concept itself is, it's funny and camp, but she also did bring this sort of like fantasy horror element into it that I appreciated because it felt like a unique perspective on horror as well.
And last up, we have October 3rd.
Now going into this challenge, October obviously had a disadvantage, but the biggest crime they made is it just didn't follow the Final Destination formula at all. There was no dead fake outs. There were no moments where we're like, oh, is the clown gonna die? So they had the dead scene and the video was so well produced. Like that looked professional with the music and everything, the effects, just the camera work. Everything looked on point. It just didn't follow the Final Destination formula.
It was very bizarre. The mood was very weird, and this was my least favorite, I think, of all of them.
So I think that they had, you know, good elements, like they shot it well, they edited it well, and I think that they had that a kind of like weird surrealist vibe to it that could have been really interesting if they had any kind of plot or any kind of connection to Final Destination. I think for me, it was just not fitting the brief and not fun to watch. It wasn't fun to watch, sorry.
October's runway though was one of my favorites. This was actually scary. This was spooky. This was giving like Conjuring Universe villain. It was giving like creepy demon of the woods. And October's performance ability really came into play with the way that they performed it. And like, it really felt like a character. It really felt like, you know, this could be in a horror movie and I would be like, yeah, this is creepy. I'm down.
I love the location they chose to film this runway because really it added to the ambiance.
Yeah, I couldn't agree more. This was probably my favorite runway this week. I think that like it was genuinely scary. It felt like something from a horror movie. The look itself, I love that they went to the extent of like actually adding detail, like making the dress look distressed, making it look dirty, like putting in the effort to, you know, create a full look that feels like it exists within the same world.
It is time for the final judgment.
Tell me. Show me to me, please.
AJ Knox, you should really get that finger checked. AJ, you are safe.
Okay, thank God I'm in the top.
Dantasia, great job this week. You are safe.
I'm high this week. Work. Okay.
Helena Boy, gagging on Lana's banana was a choice, but the one that got you the challenge win. Congratulations, Helena. You are the winner of this week's challenge.
Fuck yeah.
Work, Helena.
I told you I ate this one up. I told you. Oof.
Good job, Helena.
I felt this one. I mean, I was feeling the other ones too, but I felt this one.
Yay, Helena, West Coast diva. I'm so happy. West Coast represented this week. I'm so happy.
Good job, Helena. Yeah, I'm happy. For you.
This doesn't sound genuine just because I'm like really tired.
That's bullshit. She didn't fucking die. She didn't fucking die. That is absolute bullshit. Sorry, Helena. You're cool. That is the wrong choice.
You win $100 cash prize and round 3 power up. Stay tuned to find out what it is.
$100, Richard. Feels correct.
Lana V. Lana Banana was a total hit. You, my dear, are safe.
Yes, Lana.
Oh my God.
Jesus Weiss, this week in the game of Uno, you drew a bad hand. We are sorry, but you are one of the bottom 2 placing warriors. David Puck, your sponge did not scrub the competition, but it still made you stand out. You are safe.
Look at me, low again.
Woo! Which means October 3rd. Third challenge was not the charm for you. We are sorry, but you are also a bottom 2 facing warrior.
October in the bottom 2!
Oh shit.
October's in the bottom?
Again! What the fuck? I'm about to have a great time with this one.
Let's go!
This is what I've been waiting for. I don't even care. Thank you, thank you.
Jesus and October, it is now time for the 2 of you to participate in the drag duel to the death! To the song, Black Cat, by Janet Jackson.
Honestly, if Jesus fucking, like, eats October,
oh, wow, because October has been talking about this lip sync, so let's see it.
Everyone, you're about to see the most amazing lip sync you've ever seen in your life.
Ah, I'm in the bottom 2!
Oh, bitch, you're about to watch this lip sync? Okay.
Warriors, ready your weapons and let the drag duel commence!
Man.
Work, October, bitch, you better work.
Oh my God, October is eating this up.
Can I say something? They're so ugly. Both of them are so ugly. Bye, Jesus. I'm so sorry. Bye, Jesus. I don't like her, but October 8th, not, so.
Well, look at the material. What do you have to say, Bootsy?
You should both be so proud of yourself. However, we have made the final decision. Jesus Weiss, we are sorry. But you are the next warrior to be eliminated.
It makes sense. It's my time to go. It's my time to go. I'm not gonna cry on camera.
Jesus, sister, I love you. I love the time that I had with you. Girl, you are sickening. You're so unique. You're so talented. Your mind is just different. I just think this week was not your week, but bitch, I love you and we're gonna be sisters for life.
Jesus Weiss, your creativity was truly unmatched. You presented us with the ideas that were out of this world. And you fought to the very end, but this was just your time.
I hate that we never got to squash really whatever was going on between us.
Yeah, I'm sad that Jesus is gone. Vuho and then Jesus. I would say those are the two most aesthetically interesting and creative people in the cast, and then I would put myself there also. So who am I gonna be next?
It is sad to say goodbye to Jesus because they're one of the least annoying people in the cast.
We love and appreciate everything that you've brought into this competition. Thank you for sharing your art with us. Congratulations, October. You win the lip sync battle and you move on to the next challenge.
Nobody was gonna beat that lip sync. I'm sorry. I could say, anybody could have won. But like.
Now we are gonna save Helena's power up for next episode because let's just say she has a lot of very tough decisions to make.
For the full unedited content, a bunch of behind the scenes footage, and the chance to join the Discord and chat with the judges and the warriors, will join our Patreon today.
This is also the only way that we are funding this season, so every donation helps.
Also, if you want to have a piece of Bootsy with you, I am selling outfits that I'm wearing on the show each week. So you can go and check out my Instagram at bootsy.ca and check out my stories or the saved story called The Drag Sale. I remove items as I sell them, so whatever is still up is still available.
All right, folks, that is all for this week, but we will see you next week for a high-flying, spandex-wearing hero and villain showdown. And remember, there are very, very important rules that you have to follow in order to survive a horror movie, but I can't remember them. Let me look at my list. I'll be right back.
Next time on Drag Duel.
This week, the warriors will be paired up in Drag Duel's first team challenge.
Oh my God.
This challenge has certainly come with some complications.
Yeah, so I'm flying back to the UK for 2 weeks right in the middle of this challenge. So I'm having to super speed everything.
I am abso-fucking-lutely dreading trying to figure out how to fix this.
There were so many little details when you look at this look.
It was missing so much detail. It was really just a stretched dress, sadly.
I gotta be honest, there's nothing about this look that I like.